for your presence today. I also would like to acknowledge Engineer Marquillo, Pastor Sergano, this is Agabao, and very familiar faces here. But before everyone begins to think that I'm delivering the second of the story address, I wanted to share a short but meaningful message, something that I also try to live by. There is this story of an OFW who did well abroad and was able to earn and send back home his hard-earned money for the construction of his dream house. After many years, the project was completed. Behold, it was a big and beautiful house that any neighbor could envy. But there was a problem. The house was built on the wrong lot. And not only that, the owner of the lot wanted the house removed. Parents, grandparents, ladies and gentlemen, we all want to be victorious in life. I think that is one of the reasons why we are here today, to celebrate and share the joy of every graduate and parent in this milestone. And of course, that is what our theme for today's event is about, being victorious in life. We want to be winners in life. We don't want to lose. We want to rule. We want to succeed. We move from one adventure to another, collecting trophies, honors, degrees, and achievements from one competition to another. And because of that, we invest our youth, our energy, our knowledge, our precious time, money, and resources for great and noble goals in life, and ultimately to experience what they call a good life. Unfortunately, it is not unlikely that even after we have achieved our cherished goals and dreams in life, a high-paying job, a successful professional career, a beautiful house, a loving spouse, wonderful kids, and maybe for some, a million likes on our Facebook post, we would still end up disappointed, dissatisfied, and unhappy as we wonder what worthy challenge remains to be conquered. As God's creation, we have been designed to rule, to be fruitful and productive. Genesis 1:26-28. Which explains why we compete, why we race, and why we pursue things so as not to be left behind, thinking that such worldly achievements would make us successful. However, as we pursue success, God has also placed eternity in our hearts. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 10. A huge vacuum that we try to fill in our lifetime. Sadly, if we don't get it right, if we have a wrong thinking, a perspective that is contrary to God's plan for us, we might end up just like OFW, who invested all he had in building a house on the wrong lot. Dear graduates, and also for those who still feel and think like young graduates, I challenge and exhort you to live a life that is rich towards God, and that is to succeed at what truly matters. I have served in the military for almost 3 decades. I have listened to great leaders speak. I have attended lectures of distinguished individuals. I have read books of great authors. Amidst new perspectives, paradigms, models, and philosophies on success, the Word of God has not changed and will always remain the same. For graduates, in order to succeed in life, in order to be victorious, guard your heart. Guard the cravings of your heart. In Luke 12:15, it says, Watch out! Be on your guard against all kinds of greed. Life does not consist in an abundance of possessions. Remember this, success is not based on what you have or what you have achieved. Don't be like the rich fool in the parable who was never satisfied and wanted more, even if his barns were already full. In Mark 8:36 it says, "For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul?" Success in God's perspective is not about accumulating wealth, fame, and power. And in the justice, King Solomon found these things as meaningless and a great misfortune. For a person who may order with wisdom, knowledge, and skill, and then they must leave all the old to another who has not toiled for it. In the book titled Light Bulbs, it says there, "The best things in life are not things." True success lies not in what we give for ourselves, but in what can enrich others. To succeed is to have the right attitude, that is, by guarding your heart from greed, from an attitude of accumulation and possession. On the other hand, true success is not measured on what we have, but on how much treasure we have stored in heaven. In Matthew 6:19-21, it says, "Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." The fault of the rich man in the parable is that he had a wrong view of success, one that is based on accumulation and possession, a self-centered pursuit of counterfeit success. In other words, the road towards true success is knowing where to set our hearts on. Therefore, I challenge you to aim for success that lasts. Instead of being fixated on temporal things, strive for things that would outlast your earthly existence. Invest on what is most important, your relationship with God. Someday, when we finally appear before God, it will either be a time of great joy or deep sorrow. Dear graduates, true success is not about us. It is all about God. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Matthew 6:33. Pursue God's kingdom to a life that strives to become Christ-like, a life that abounds in good works, and a life of soul winning and discipleship. To succeed, one must have the right mindset, that is, by having a kingdom-minded mentality. For this world is not our home, we are just passing through. Our final destination is in heaven, hence, we store our treasures in heaven as we offer to God's Word our life. Life spelled L-I-F-E could also be an acronym for L for labor, I for influence, F for finances, and E for expertise. We can give our labor by serving in the ministry as a missionary, pastor, public school teacher, choir member, deacon, or in any other capacity. We may also use our influence to open doors for ministry. We may give our finances or our money, or we may share our expertise to support God's work. However, to succeed, it's not enough that we have the right attitude and mindset in life. We must also succeed in balancing life. The life of our Lord Jesus Christ is the best example for this. In Luke 2:52, it says, "Jesus grew both in body and in wisdom, gaining favor with God and people."